Hello students, today we are going to begin with a new subject, that is service marketing. So let's begin with the introduction. So we all know that we are surrounded by so many services. You can find out every day, every point of a life, we need services. So let's see what exactly services are and what things are involved in services and service marketing. So beginning with this, and we are going to study in today's video what concepts of service, contribution and reason for the growth of service sector, especially in India, differences in goods and services in marketing, characteristics of services, concept of service marketing triangle, service marketing mix, and gap models of service quality. So let's begin with the concept. What are exactly services? So services are non-physical, intangible part of economy, as opposed to goods, which we can touch or handle. It means services are intangible and they are non-physical and they are part of our economy where we can't touch the services. So services such as banking, education, medical treatment and transportation make up the majority of the economies of the rich nation. So these things play an important role in the contribution of service. Now looking at India, so if you look at IT sector is providing huge exports and huge services for different countries also and to the nation also, and even in medical treatment also, and even banking services. So they also represent most of the emerging nations economies. So continuing this, a service is a transaction in which no physical goods are transferred from the seller to the buyer. So we are not transferring anything physical. Here just we are giving the services, okay? And the benefit of such service are held to be demonstrated by buyer's willingness to make the exchange. Plays an important role. If you go to a doctor, you require a willingness, okay? And he will be helping you with his knowledge and skills with his services. And public services are those that society, okay, as a whole pays for. For example, nation, state and physical union are region. So these are all given by the government, state government and all. Using resources, skill, ingenuity and experience, service providers benefit service consumers. They use their skills, they use their resources and they use their experiences and they give the benefits from them. So service is intangible in nature. So that is the one of the important characteristic of service. Now let's see this example. Here we have services goods continuum. If looking to the upper to the lower, upper side is pure service and downside it is pure commodity. Teaching, pure service. House cleaning, pure service. Plumbing repair, pure service. Restaurant, pure service. Okay. And it goes on decreasing where involvement mix-up will happen. And made to major clothing, again it is services. New car you are purchasing, that is a commodity, but after purchasing a car there will be a service. Radio, again, soft drinks, salt, these all fall under the commodity. So goes on differentiation. You have plenty of, if you're going to barber shop, that is again service. There are plenty of services available in the nation. And even transportation services we can take. We can take the logistic services, which is growing heavily. So those all fall under the services. Now let's see the contribution and reason for the growth of service sector. So first of all, if you look at the contribution, okay. So the service sector is not only the dominant sector in India's GDP, but has also attracted significant foreign investment, that is FDI. Has contributed significantly to export and has provided large-scale employment in India. So India's service sector covers a wide variety of activities such as trade, hotel, restaurant, transport, storage and communication, financing, insurance, real estate, business services, community, social and personal services, and service associated with construction. Looking at 2018 data, 31.45% of India's employed population is working in the service sector. So that is one of the biggest part played, but agriculture is still dominant in India. Now looking into the market size, so the sector contributed 55.39% to India's gross value added, that is called GVA, to the financial year 20. So services sector GVA grew at CAGR of 1.4% to US dollar 1064.8 billion in financial 20 from US dollar 1005 billion in financial 16. So you can see the change, it has grown drastically. So net export estimated in financial 20 from service stood at US dollar 214.14 billion, while import was at US dollar 131 billion in financial 20. So we are exporting more services, especially IT industry, tourism, and the health sector. So Nikkei India Service Purchasing Managers Index, that is called PMI, Purchasing Managers Index, stood at 14.6 in May 2020. So indicating a contraction as COVID-19 led shutdown impaired businesses, just it is for 2020, but it is contributing very high. So due to the pandemic, so there is a slowdown in the service sector business. Now looking at the GDP data contribution, if you see, so agriculture represent blue, the dark blue is represented by the industry, and the light gray color is represented by the services. So if you look at the share of GDP, so the contribution of service sector is increasing day by day in the GDP comparing to the, and even in 2009 comparing to 2019, the contribution has increased very highly because of the development and policies made by. After the 1992 India, 1991-1992, the liberalization and globalization privatization policy has helped India to develop very drastically. Now, if you look at advantage in India, why service sector has advantage, a robust demand. There is a huge demand for software services for India. If you look at the data and even healthcare industries and medical tourism. So medical tourism is again contributing more in India's economy. Competitive advantage. So skilled power is huge, especially IT and ITES. Okay, they are available at low cost, and rapidly increasing youth population in India. So that is again contributing, and agriculture, people are migrating to the service sector. Policy support, yes, government of India is working to remove many trade barriers to service and tabled a draft legal text on trade facilitation service to WTO in 2017. And increasing investment in FDI, yes, FDI is flowing heavily in service sector. $82 billion between April 2000 and March 2020. This much FDI has flown into service sector. Now, why growth in service sector? So basically, low cost of operation and tax advantage in Indian market, especially operation is very low cost operation, rapid industrialization and growth of IT parks in the country, supportive government policies. You have seen after 1991-1992, there have been tremendous changes has happened in the industrialization, especially in the IT sector. Bangalore, if you concern more. Now Hyderabad is there, Pune is there, and Ghaziabad is there. So many are there. Availability of technically skilled manpower and readily available resources in the country. So this is one of the biggest reason we can say. Rapid introduction of IT technologies in major sectors such as telecom, BFSI. So you have seen the very highly change. Nowadays, everyone is coming to services, and especially IT is helping very much in telecom industry. Internet service providing, broadband service providing, and digital, digital TV. You can take the example of Giga Fiber. Reliance has, Airtel has their own network system. Next is strong growth in export demand. So Indian export is more, especially in the IT services. Use of new technologies like cloud computing and government is, cloud computing is increased a lot. So this is increasing the development in the service sector, especially in IT. Government established SEZ. So special economic zones are contributing very high to the service sector. Now, again, coming to how it is developing, some more points. In developing country, the government has to take responsibility for provision of basic service, for example, hospital, educational, post and telegraph services, police station, court, village administrative offices, municipal corporation, defense, transport, banks, insurance companies. So these are all most majorly governed by the government of the nation. The development of agriculture and industry lead to the development of services, yes, such as trade, okay, transportations, storage, cold storage facility, etc. So greater the development of the primary and secondary sector, more would be the demand for even services also. As an income level rise of Indian people, certain section of people start demanding many more services, such as eating out, tourism, shopping, private hospitals, private schools, professional training, etc. So this is increasing very high because of the rise in the level of income. So this change was quite sharp in cities, especially in big cities. Yes, if you look at our urban area, and no doubt in rural area also there is a development of services, but in urban area it is developing very huge. Over the past decade or so, certain new services such as those based on information and communication technology that we call IT have become important and essential. We have already discussed that IT is contributing very huge and highly for the development of service sector. Government policy of privatization has also led to growth of this sector. So we discussed regarding 1991 policy. So that has led to develop this sector. A large number of workers are engaged in services such as small shopkeepers, repair person, transport person, etc. So if you look at India, so this is huge in number. So if you look at entire sector has not grown. Large number of people engaged as construction workers, maid, peon, small shopkeepers do not find any change in their life, but slow on there, that is also increasing. But we have seen banking, health, education, finance sector has increased a lot. Now let's understand the difference between goods and services in marketing. So let's start with that. Goods are the material item that the customer are ready to purchase for a price. Okay, it's a material. Services are amenities, benefits, or facility provided by the other person. Okay, this is the first difference. Coming to the second one, goods are tangible items. That is the basic difference between services and good, that tangible and intangibility. So when the buyer purchases the goods by the paying the consideration, the ownership of goods moves from seller to buyer. Okay, but conversely, the ownership of services is not transferable. Whoever has purchased the service, that can be done only to them. The evaluation of services is difficult because every service provider has different approach of carrying out services. So it is hard to judge whose service are better than other as compared to the goods. And the last one, goods can be returned to or exchanged with the seller. Okay, but it is not possible to return or exchange services once they are provided. That can't be exchanged. Now let's continue. Goods can be distinguished from the seller. On the other hand, services and service provider are inseparable. Okay, that is another biggest character. A particular product will remain same regarding physical characteristic and specification, but in services can never remain same. So there comes the homogeneous and heterogeneous. So goods can be stored for future use, but services are time bound. So that is, if not availed in given time, then it cannot be stored. First of all, the goods are produced, they are traded and finally consumed. But when it comes to the services, they are produced and consumed same time, simultaneously. So these were the basic difference between the goods and services. Now let's understand the characteristic of services. The first come the intangibility. You cannot see, taste it, see it, heard, touch or smell before the purchase. So judgment therefore based on opinion of someone, attitude and feelings, perception and experience of yours. Example is education provision. That is intangible, but you can feel it later. Inseparability. Yes, the production that we have discussed, that production and consumption are inseparable in service. So their creation or performance or consumption are often identical and distribution roles integrated. So the product cannot usually exist without the customer. Example, restaurant services. They are identical. They are produced and consumed there. Heterogeneity. Yes. Standardization of outputs is generally difficult in service sector. How one you have treated with one customer will not be treated with another. So that is, there is no homogeneous. So quality and conformity and judgment is difficult in advanced purchase. Example, tourism products. Perishability, if you see, services are perishable and cannot be stored. While short capacity is lost forever with fluctuation in demand. So in transport and travel, if you purchase a ticket, you need to fly before cancellation. Once it is you gone, the service is gone. You can't take next ticket with the same price. Next comes the ownership. Yeah, customers only have access to or use of the service rather than ownership. There is no ownership transfer, patents or inventories, and payment is for hire or temporary use. Example, you can say leisure facility. If you go to a resort, okay, you can pay, you can use it, then you can go. So these were the main characteristics of service. Now let's move to another topic, that is service marketing triangle. So what exactly service marketing triangle? So it states the relationship between promoter, employee and deliverer. So here we see the interlinked group that work together to develop the service, promote the service and deliver the services. So these key players are labeled on points of triangle. One comes as a company, second customer and the provider that are nothing but the employees of the company. So in this triangle, so we have three types of marketing carried out. Okay, external marketing, internal marketing and interactive marketing has to be seen. So external marketing will be done by company and employees. Internal marketing will be done through company and customers. Okay, and interactive session or interactive marketing happens through customer and employees. So that is the relationship between these three is called the service marketing triangle. Now if you look at this image, so company, provider and customer. So the to the company and customer, actual marketing that will be done by the company using advertising, sales promotion, public relations and direct marketing through emails. Now, if you look at internal marketing between company and provider, that is employee. So vertical communication and horizontal communication between both parties. And with the company and customer, there will be public relation happen where customer will contact to company also. And company go through advertising and sale promotion and excelling. And through public relations, the customer can always contact with the company. Now coming to the provider and customer. So interactive marketing, we say personal selling. So we call it as a service encounter where customer and provider exactly meets to provide the service. Customer service center and service scapes and even social media. So this all fall under the interactive marketing between provider and the customer. So this is the basic model of the service triangle. Now that's most important part, that is the 7 P's of service marketing or marketing mix we call. So we know product has 4 P's, that is promotion, product, price and place. But when it comes to service, 3 more are added, okay, extended. That is people, physical evidence and process. Okay, so let's see what exactly one each of the P stand for. When it comes to service marketing, the product in service marketing mix is intangible that we have seen. Like physical products such as soap or detergent, so service products cannot be measured. Okay, so tourism industry or education industry can be excellent example. At the same time, service products are heterogeneous, perishable and cannot be owned that we have already seen in the characteristics. So the service product thus has to be designed with care. So obviously, because it is not like product, not standardized. Okay. Generally, a blueprint is done, define the service product. If you look at example of hotel industry or any restaurant or any lodge, so So blueprint will be prepared before establishing a restaurant business. So this service blueprint defines exactly how the product is going to be. So that blueprint we will study further in our next modules. So the basic blueprint will help the process, how the flow happen, what are the defined rules, how process things comes and operations happen. Now, like next is a place. So in case of service, where is the service product going to be located? So the best place to open and petrol pump is on the highway or in the city. The reason, the more movement, so more footfall. A place where there is a minimum traffic is wrong location to start a petrol pump. So that plays an important role regarding place. Similarly, a software company will be better place of business hub with a lot of companies nearby rather than being placed in a town or a rural area because there are no availability of more business hubs. So location, or you can see no promotion. So they have become critical factor, obviously, in the service marketing mix. Services are easy to be duplicated, and hence it is generally the brand which sets a service apart from its counterpart. You might have seen, went to so many hospitals, but you can find the best hospital because they are branded with their services. You will find, you might have gone to hotels, you might have gone to Kamat restaurants, you might get so many service industries. You might have got Domino's, you might have gone to a Pizza Hut. So you might find a difference, McDonald's, okay, you can go on to KFC Chicken. So you will find the difference. So you will find some of the banks and telecom companies promoting themselves rigorously. Axis Bank, if you see, and compare with the SBI, you will find the difference. So why is that? It is because competition. Yes, that matters a lot. In this service sector is generally high, and promotions is necessary to survive. So banks, IT companies, and dot-coms place themselves above the rest by advertising or promotions, you will find out. So recently you have gone through the Big Billion Days, if you watch. If you use this card, 10% discount, use this card, 10% discount, additional discount for this card holder. So those all are part in the promotional activity. Pricing in service, more difficult in case of products. So pricing is not easy in service compared to the product, because cost of production can be easily evaluated in product sector, not in services. If you are a restaurant owner, you can price people only for the food they're serving, but then who will pay for the nice ambience you have built up for your customer? When you are sitting in a hotel, you will see a nice hotel, everything, but you will pay only for the food, the enjoy which you are using, but you are not giving a payment for the ambience which is used to look nicely where you are sitting. Okay, and who will pay for the band you have for the music? Same thing happen. So thus these elements have to be taken into consideration while costing. Generally, service pricing involves taking into consideration labor, material cost, and overhead cost. By adding a profit markup, you get final service pricing. But you can also read about pricing strategies. We'll see those things. So next comes the most important part is the additional 3 P's, and in that first is people. Okay, the best, biggest important element in service marketing mix is people. Okay, people define a service. If you have an IT company, software engineers defines you. If you have a barber shop, a big beauty center, the worker who are working skilled, they define you. If you have a restaurant, your chef and service staff defines you. If you are into banking, employees in your branch and their behavior toward customer defines you. So in case of service marketing, people can make or break an organization. So most important role played in service sector is people. So there's many companies nowadays are involved into specially getting their staff training, interpersonal skill, and customer service with a focus toward customer satisfaction. In fact, many companies have to undergo accreditation to show that their staff is better than the rest. So that called as a USP, unique selling product. So if you look at education industry, they will market themselves accredited with the A grade, NAC accredited, NBA accredited, ISO accredited. So these all comes, they tell about their quality of services and the people, quality people they are having. Now, second is process. So service process is the way in which a service is delivered to the end customers. So if you look at example, McDonald's and FedEx. So both companies have tried on their quick service, and the reason they can do because of the confidence on their process, how they have designed. So FedEx, if you look at India, there are huge service options available. So being on the world, that gives their process, and that will be added value to that particular company. 30 minutes pizza delivery or money will be back. So fastest service, 1 day services, 2 day services. So that matters a lot. Come on Sunday and get treated. Okay, within 1 day you will be treated with your tooth problem. So these are all fallen into process. On the top of it, the demand of these services is such that they have to deliver optimal without a loss of quality. Yes, that is important. Not only the process, but with the quality. So most important for the delivering product is most plays an important role. So because it is critical component in service blueprint, wherein before establishing a service, the company define exactly what should be the process of the service product reaching the end customer. So that will be designed through the blueprint. Next, the seventh one, again, matters a lot in service, that is physical evidence. So it is an important element. As said before, services are intangible in nature. And to create better customer experience, tangible elements are also delivered with the services. If you look at example, you go to an hotel or you go to a restaurant, you will find chair, tables, nicely designed, attracting atmosphere over there. Okay, interior designing and the good food. So which are restaurant which have ambient lighting. So you can see the music along with it and good seating arrangement. This also serve a good food. So which one you will prefer? The one with the nice ambience, that's physical evidence. So that is most important in the service segment. So these we have seen 7 P's of marketing. You can see these all physical evidences. We can example. Now let's understand the gap. Service gap. So we have total 5 gaps. And we will study each different model. Okay. So first gap is called the gap between customer gap is a, okay. So this gap is called consumer expectation and company perception. That is the gap. So this gap arises when the company or management does not correctly perceive what the customers want. So we always, if company fails to understand the what exactly customer is looking for, then that is called gap one. So why this happens? Insufficient marketing research done by the service company, poorly interpreted information about the customer's expectation when the data is collected, and lack of communication and understanding between the frontline personnel and the top level management. So service encounter wherever it happens, they are the main people, so frontline people. So if there is a communication gap between the policy maker at the top level, so this gap arises. Example, if you see a wireless telephone service provider may think that the customer want lower tariffs for calls, but actually the consumer is bothered about the network coverage which is providing. They might say we are providing less price for the high values and all, but might be customer is more bothered about the network coverage. That is gap. In a hospital, the administration may think patient want better food, but patient may be more concerned about the care given by nurses and support staff that values more rather than the food. So this has to be identified between the consumer and the provider. Next comes the gap. So gap two, it is between the management and company perception and service standards. So here the management might correctly perceive what the customer wants, but may not set an appropriate performance standard. If gap one is not there, they might have understand what exactly the customer want, but if they fail to understand and if they fail to set the performance standard, then this gap arises. So why this happened? Because of the lack of planning by the management, lack of management commitment, and unclear service design. Now, looking at the example to the gap two and travel and tourism company, the management may instruct their employees to respond to booking inquiries of customers fast and efficiently. But the management has not mentioned how fast and efficiently. They have to set standard to their process. How fast, time, everything time bound. So that has to be mentioned with the standard. An IT company may ask their employees to solve customer complaints quickly, but it doesn't mention how quickly. Within 24 hours, 2 days, 3 days, etc. So some companies mention that within three working days, we will solve this. So that is that standard has been set. If they are not communicated it to the customer, sorry, employees, so this standard is failed and this gap arises. Now let's move to the gap. This gap tries to explain between the standard of service and service delivery. Okay, so this gap may arise owing to the service person, the reason being poor training, incapability or unwilling to meet the set service standards. So why reason happens? So deficiency in human resource policies such as ineffective recruitment, role ambiguity, role conflict, improper evaluation and compensation system. So you might have seen hotels and industry where you might have feel the delivery person or a waiter is not good at all. So not speaking good with you, not understanding your requirements. So these gaps come because they are not fit for the job. Ineffective internal marketing, failure to match the demand and supply, and lack of proper customer education and training. So this gaps comes up. So example, if you see in an upscale restaurant, if the waiter or service is not courteous and hospitable, the customer may become unhappy with the entire service experience, even if the food served complies with his quality standards. Food is awesome, but waiter service is not good. So whole service provide fall here and customer will become dissatisfied. So this become with the gap three. If you go to hair salon like Lakme salon, the management has set standard and has specification regarding service quality. If a hairdresser is inexperienced and doesn't do a good job of cutting their client's hair, this result in customer dissatisfaction due to the gap three. So the whole brand value will decreases. Now coming to the gap four, okay. So gap between service delivery and external communication. So consumer expectations are highly influenced by statements made by company representatives and advertisement. So there are numerous factors which influence the customer. So this gap arises when these assumed expectations are not fulfilled at the time of delivery of the services. So promises are made. If they are not met, then obviously customer will become dissatisfied. Reasons behind this: over-promising in external communication campaign. Within 3 days, within this, you will be cured, you will become white, we will provide you such services. So fastest services. So these over-promising will make to lose the customer and even dissatisfaction, lead to dissatisfaction. Failure to manage customer expectation. Okay, failure to perform according to the specification. Now, if you look at an example, hotel printed on voucher may have clean and furnished rooms. But when we have seen an advertisement or website, it's everything is looking clean. And the customer booked the seat. If we go there and he see that exactly is not there. But in reality, it may be poorly maintained in case customer expectations are not met. Coming to insurance company's example, promise large return to the policyholder, but in reality, the fine print in the policy may be different than what was promised to the customer. And individual may go to shopping mall on his friend's recommendation, thinking that 50% off sale is still on his favorite store, only to find that the sale concluded the previous day. So these all the examples, you can easily understand why gap four happened. The communication should be proper. Now comes the gap five. So it is between expected service and pursued service. What expectation and what the service is pursued. So this gap between customer expect from the service and what they think they have received. So this gap arises when the consumer misinterprets the service quality. So this may happen due to customer's own bias or prejudice. Customer expectation is what the customer expects according to available resource. And it is influenced by cultural background, family lifestyle, personality, demographic, advertising, experience with similar products and information available online. So if you look at example, when a student signs up for an online course, he expects the course to increase his domain knowledge. However, after taking few lectures online, he may think that he hasn't received the perceived amount of knowledge that has gone only with the basic things. A doctor may ask the patient to keep visiting him often in short span of time to show and ensure care. But the patient may interpret this as an indication that something is really wrong with his health. So here the doctor has to be very caring about that thing. Okay. Often coming continuously to him, show how are you feeling, continuously coming. So obviously the patient will think doctor is coming continuously to me, then there is a very big reason behind it. So we have concluded with all topics here. So make sure, understand it, write the notes, go with your textbook so you have to understand more and more. Thank you very much.